Hey y'all, how are you guys doing? Pastor Peter here again. Some of you may or may not know that I used to play volleyball in high school. And I played on the Temple City team, and afterwards I played for 2-on-2 at the YMCA. And I played different intramural leagues, such as the Japanese American, Asian American leagues, West Side. I played beach a little, and just continued to play on different leagues even after high school. I wasn't good enough to play college. I tried out for my university's college team, but man, those guys are just really, really good. So I was never able to make it to my Biola club team. But anyways, I used to play volleyball. And what was interesting is I never intended to learn how to hit the ball with my left hand, my left arm. I never intended to be ambidextrous because I'm a right-handed person. I'm a right-handed hitter. I play offside hitter on the right side and power hitter on the left. And briefly, I played middle. But most of the time, I played the right side outside hitter because I was never the best hitter, but I was better than the others, but not as best as, of course, the power hitter. And I didn't mind because on the right side, you can get these massively wide angles that go straight down parallel to the net. And a lot of people aren't ready for that. And if there's not good blockers, you can just hit past the block, especially if they're blocking line and not angle. Anyways, accidentally, I found out that after a while, I became ambidextrous, meaning an ambidextrous hitter, hitting with both my right and left hand, right and left arm. And how that happened was this, is that if you're a volleyball player, you know that in order to practice hitting or in order to warm up before each game, or even during your practice times, part of practice is just hitting the ball against the wall. And what I mean is spiking down, just standing and spiking the ball down with your right hand, like handball, down to the ground, then allowing it to bounce back to the wall, and then it'll bounce back to you, and immediately you hit the ball again, so that the ball will then bounce to the ground and hit the wall and then bounce back to you. And you just keep doing that as much as you can in order to warm up your strong arm. For mine, it was my right side arm. And what happened was that from time to time, the ball would go too far to the left for me to be able to hit with my right arm. So in order to save it, I would hit with my left arm. And in the beginning, it was really sloppy and it wasn't really that much of a save. But after, I would say, about the 50th time. Now, I know 50 sounds like a lot, but if you play volleyball, 50 actually isn't a lot. It's actually very little, because if you play volleyball, even as a hobby, you spike the ball a lot and you practice with the ball a lot, with the volleyball a lot. And after about the 50th time, I found out that I was starting to hit with my left in order to save the ball, quote-unquote save the ball, more often. And it was sort of muscle memory or cognitive memory at the point where I would just immediately hit with my left if the ball went too far outside towards my left shoulder for my right arm to be able to hit it. And so I then thought, you know what, why don't I just practice with my left hand then, because I'm already used to hitting the ball with my right hand. Why don't I just practice with my left hand and left arm? And so I started hitting the ball also with my left arm, as well as with my right arm, back and forth whenever I would do the hitting drills, or whenever I'm doing drills by myself against the wall. And after a while, during games, I found that I was able to be ambidextrous, meaning that if I went up to hit, went up to spike, I would be able to hit the ball with my right hand, or I would be able to spike the ball with my left. Now, of course, my left arm wasn't as strong as my right, but I could still do it, and it could still go down pretty hard. And I just kept doing that. I just kept practicing with both my right and left arms, and I became ambidextrous where I can hit and spike with both arms. And so here's the cool thing, the advantage about it, is that a lot of people, when they look at you, your opponents, your opposing team, or even your friends who are just playing with you, if they know you're a right-sided hitter, or I mean a right-handed hitter, they will be looking at that right arm for them to place their blocks. So they're gonna jump up and they're gonna put their two hands as a wall against your right arm, and they're gonna watch for angles. If they don't realize that you can actually hit with your left hand, that puts you at an advantage because you can go up and fake that you're going to use your right hand. And because whenever you do a spike, you're throwing both of your hands up anyways, you can then switch to hitting it with your left hand and left arm, and therefore have the advantage and hit it past the blockers most of the time. Now, of course, after a while, they'll get wind of it, they'll get wise to what you're doing, and then they'll watch out for it. But at least for the first two times, first couple of times, you have the advantage there. And if you're hitting from the left side, you have the advantage of being able to hit with your left arm, which gives you these massively shallow angles parallel to the net, which is always amazing to see. Of course, if the opposing team is smart, they're going to have someone there on the far side to be able to bounce back or pass back or dig those angles. But the thing is, you have that option with your left hand. So anyways, this is a natural way of developing an ambidextrous hitting skill with both your right and left arms. And you can incorporate this in your practice easily. Whenever the ball, if you're a right-handed player, or if you're a left-handed player and you want to grow your skill in your right arm, whenever the ball goes towards that opposing side and you want to save it, don't use your strong arm, use your weaker arm. And then after a few months to a few years, it's going to be natural. So hope you incorporate that into your game and into your practice, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.